The Speech Resource Company presents Historic Moments in Speech.
I'm Robert Wikstrom with another chapter of Historic Moments in Speech. It's back to politics as we follow the evolution of Donald Trump, beginning at the beginning of his first dive into the political arena. In late 1999, the real estate magnate from New York announced the creation of a presidential exploratory committee. Trump had actually considered a run in 1988 as a Republican, but chose not to go for it. It was Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura that persuaded him to seek the nomination from his Reform Party. That race included commentator Pat Buchanan, whom Trump attacked as a Hitler lover. Trump began making appearances on TV and radio talk shows with policy announcements. He rolled out a tax proposal that featured a one-time 14.25% net worth tax to be applied to individuals with assets greater than $10 million, with a revenue of some $5.7 trillion earmarked to wipe out the national debt. On his first campaign stop in Miami, he spoke before the Cuban American National Foundation, denouncing Cuban President Fidel Castro and favoring the U.S. embargo against that country. In an unusual move, Trump suggested possible cabinet members should he win the office. They included Senator John McCain as Secretary of Defense, Congressman Charles Rangel for Secretary of Housing and Urban Development, Colin Powell as possible Secretary of State, and General Electric CEO Jack Welch as Secretary of Treasury. He also suggested as a possible running mate, Oprah Winfrey. In January, Trump and his friend Ventura held a press conference following a Reform Party fundraiser in Minnesota, where he claimed he had yet to decide whether to run officially, but asserted it would be a disaster for the Reform Party if Pat Buchanan received the nomination. Soon-to-be candidate Donald Trump speaks to the press on this day, Friday, January 7th, 2000.
Well, I have tremendous respect for Jesse. He's a friend of mine, but I have tremendous, beyond that, I have tremendous respect for Jesse. I always have. I've known him a long time. But I'm not here to ask for Jesse's support at this point, because in all fairness to Jesse, I haven't even made the determination to run. If I do, I'll be back here very quickly, because there's nobody's support that I'd want more than his. But at this point, and as I said before in our speech, I'm not here for that. I'm here as a friend of Jesse, and I'm a big supporter of Jesse. I think he's done a great job, and I have a lot of I'm in Minnesota. I come to Minnesota quite a bit over the years. I know a lot of people that live here, and they love this man. He's done an amazing job.
Governor, is Mr. Trump the kind of candidate you can endorse for president?
Again, as Donald said, he's not a candidate yet, but certainly if he announces that he will be a candidate, he will absolutely get my full consideration.
Mr. Trotsky, if you do decide to run, would you consider Minnesota a hub, an important key state for you, since this is the home of the leading Reform Party elected official in the country?
Well, Jesse's the one person that went out, and not just with talk, he went out and got himself elected to be the governor of a major state. So, you know, he not only is Minnesota would it be important, but Jesse would be very important. Having, if I do decide to do this, which I very well might, Jesse's support would be very important to me in many ways. A gentleman got up and said, oh, but Mr. Trump, you know, you have a lot of wealth and this and that, and other people have wealth. I said, yeah, but I created my wealth. There's a big difference between creating wealth and being a member of the Lucky Sperm Club, which a number of different people that are right now running are.
I'm not a member of that either. I'll throw.
There are a few of them out there. Yes.
In your book, you speak about how your candidacy might be more appealing in a time of economic distress. Is that one of the factors that's going into your decision? Wait-and-see attitude toward the economy in general?
Maybe a little bit, but I think generally speaking, a Reform Party candidate will do better when the economy isn't doing so bad. I'm not saying this is a good thing or a bad thing. I'm saying that I think to get votes, a Reform Party candidate. Now, if the economy happens to tube in the next period of time, which hopefully it won't, but if it does, I think the Reform Party candidate would do better.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.